Each render context can store a few values like camera settings, render settings, object transformations, different materials, or even collection visibility, and so on. This is extremely useful for when you want the exact same scene, just with a different material or world lights. With your render context selected, right-click on the material and select Store Property. Now, if you go into a new context and change the material, the change only occurs in this specific context. The previous material in the first context stays the same. You can do this with the camera settings as well, allowing you to change the camera's f-stop, for example. Another useful property to store is object's position. Sometimes your client wants to see how a certain shelf looks a bit higher or lower, you simply never know. You can find all added or removed properties if you scroll down to this tab. If you want to change collection's visibility for render context, navigate to RenderSet Preferences using this button and scroll down to Options. Here you can enable what visibility settings affect render context and which do not. I enabled this first icon for enabling or disabling the whole collections. Now my contexts remember which collections I've left disabled and which are left visible, allowing me to have multiple versions of the same interior with different furniture. And that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!